everyone, and welcome to another Toad video demonstration. My name is Gary Jarrett, and I'm a solutions consultant for Quest Software, specializing in our database management solutions. As many of you know by now, Toad Solutions provide database professionals everywhere many important capabilities, like administration and management of your database objects, code debugging, performance tuning, compares and syncs, and a whole lot more. In this video, I'll be concentrating on giving a high-level overview of Toad for SQL Server's data compare, and along with that data compare comes a nice synchronization feature. So as you can see, I've launched Toad for SQL Server and I'm already logged into my database. As you see from the Object Explorer, I do have a gold standard database and also a dev version of that with similar tables in that database. What I'd like to do here is to compare table by table, view by view, the elements in my gold standard database to the objects in my dev one. So I'm going to highlight those two databases, right click, and launch the data compare wizard within Toad for SQL Server. Note you can make source look like target or look, you know, use target as a source. I'm going to keep my dev gold standard database as the source here and move through the wizard. The first thing that Toad does is attempt to pair for comparison reasons, table to table. So we take a look at the table names, of course. Now, it doesn't mean that you have to accept the pairing that Toad for SQL Server takes or gives you. For example, I may want to change my comparison on the target side. So in fact, highlighting my customer table on the target, I do have a derived customer table that I created. In fact, that's the table that I'd like to compare. So I just changed the pairwise comparison there and changed the target to be this derived table. Notice also that for any of the tables, I can perform column mapping. So if the column names are not the same, or there are additional columns, or some columns need to be mapped to other columns, or the columns are not in the right order, I can choose a different column for the target comparison. In these cases, in all my cases, the tables, the columns are the same, they're named the same. Note, by the way, however, and we do call this out with a different visual icon, the source column of first name has a different data type, actually same data type, but different length. Note that, and that's why that icon is different, just to identify that, make you aware of that. If you're okay with getting first name truncated on target, that's fine, leave it as it is. Otherwise, you might have to change the data type there for the first name. I'm okay with that. Notice that we chose the proper comparison key. Notice also two other things. I don't have to compare all the columns, so pick and choose. And if you wanted to be very specific about which rows, you can specify a where clause condition here, either at the source and or at the target for any of your tables to limit the comparison, all right? In this case, I'll just simply say, okay, I'm happy with that pairing up of the source and the target tables. Actually, not too happy. I don't really care about views here. So a quick way to do this, and especially true if there's hundreds of objects that have been paired between the databases. In my case, I don't care about the view. So anything that has the name view in it, I'm going to unmap so I don't have to consider those. And you'll see when I look at the total list here, I'm not going to consider any view targets for the comparison. I'm okay with all this. There's no red X's. That's great. I'm going to move through the wizard. Yeah, Toad is really known for this. Lots of flexibility in terms of settings and options. You want to ignore blobs. You want to ignore text, case in the text or white spaces. Pick and choose the things that are important to you. Otherwise, we can move through the comparison wizard. Just read now through all the data in my small databases here, you can see that most of the tables are the same and have equal and matching records. Some do not. So if I go ahead and say finish, we get a nice doc tab here representing the visual results of my data compare pairwise table to table. Now note, for example, that some of these objects have records that are only in the source and not in the target. Those will show up in green. If I had records for a table in target only and not in source, those will show up in red. But for the rest of these, I have lots of differences here, right? So this top panel will give you a list of the pairs of tables we're comparing. The middle panel here, once I choose a pair of tables that we've compared, will show you any differences. Now, by default, we're going to show you all the records. And again, light green for records that are in the source, not in the target. Records that are in the target, not in the source. However, you can choose. So in my case, I'm just interested in the differences. I'll tap that icon, and now I'm only seeing the records that are different in both source and target. That's the middle panel. By the way, I am using a side-by-side or a grouped column effect where I can see per column, source and target. If you don't like that, you can see the entire source record first and then the target record that it compares to. I kind of like the column groupings, which is really nice. And then once I highlight a specific row, I can see the details for the individual columns in that row. Now notice here in customer ID 12 record, the last name has been changed. That's a difference. But notice also something very subtle here. Yeah, there's a null value versus the high school in the education field. But in the gender field, in that column, it looks like M is different from M. Well, if I double click there, that actually takes us to a detailed cell viewer where now I can actually see the highlighted differences in the text or string or date field, whatever it might be. And you can see someone probably added a trailing space there, or undisplayable character, right? So that's the data compare doc tab that comes up as a result of the data compare wizard. Pairwise a list of tables, highlight any of those pairs, see the differences, highlight a row, see the actual row and column differences in that row. One last thing I want to show here, that is, visually speaking, it's very productive to see differences this way. What about getting the target to sync up to the source data? There's a very nice synchronization wizard that comes with the data compare. You can make source look like target or target look like source. And I'm going to do target looking like source here. I say next. Yes, I've already generated that script file right there as in a previous demo, so I'll overwrite that. Yes, you can choose your different options or settings to drop and recreate foreign keys and constraints and all that stuff. Pick and choose the things that are relevant and important to you. And then rather than running the script immediately, I want to take the opportunity to open up in a Toad editor for a couple different reasons. One is to confirm what my script will be doing. And literally, you can see there might be hundreds and thousands or tens of thousands of different records here. But more importantly, with the Toad editor comes a nice script map too. That script map is very important, especially if my script is long, because I can index my way into different parts of the script. So for example, if I wanted to see any updates on my movie title table, well, I can double click and go straight into the script where those updates are happening, right? So a very productive way to navigate through the script. And pretty much that's it for the data compare and synchronization wizard that's in our Toad for SQL Server. So I hope you found this video productive. And especially if you're using the Toad data compare and sync wizard to not only visually see your row and cell differences between pairs of tables and views, but to generate a script that syncs up data from your source and your target tables. So you'll find this and other useful videos about Toad products on our toadworld.com website. Once again, Gary Jarup here, a systems consultant for Quest Software, and I thank you for watching.